So voice in practice at 5.3, I in the second question simplify, I had solved the first sum and the second sum. Third and fourth sum you'll have to do it for homework. Okay. Now third sum of the simplify is the same as the first sum because there's a minus in between, and the second fourth sum is same as the second sum because there's a plus in between the two binomials. Okay. So first and third sum is same, second and fourth sum is same. So third and fourth sum we'll do it for homework. Practice at 5.3, simplify third and fourth for homework. Now we go on to the last expansion formula which you'll be learning in this chapter. Practice at 5.1, you learn the first expansion formula, you applied the first expansion formula, which was that x plus a into x plus b. Practice at 5.2, you applied which expansion formula? Second one, a plus b the whole cube. Practice at 5.3, which one you applied? The third expansion formula, a minus b the whole cube. And now in practice at 5.4, you will apply the fourth expansion formula, the last one which you will be learning in this chapter, that is a plus b plus c the whole square. So what is this formula? This formula is for a finding the square of a trinomial. Why trinomial? Because there are three terms, a, b, c, three terms. So how to find the square of a trinomial? What is the formula? First term square. So who is your first term? A square. Second term square, b square. Third term square, c square. Plus 2 into first term into second term. So 2 into first term into second term. Then you have got 2bc, that is 2 into second term into third term. Then you got 2ac, the 2 into first term into third term. Okay. So very easy. First term square plus second. So what does the formula say? If you have three term trinomial ka square, first term square plus second term square plus third term square plus 2 into first term into second terms, 2 into second term into third term, 2 into first into third term. Okay. So very easy. You have got a, b, c. So if you look here, first you take a and b, then you take b and c, then you take a and c. Easy. A, b, b, c, a, c. Simple. Okay. So let's do the sums. So formula, what is the formula? Who is my a? My m is my a, my b is 2n, my c is 3r. Okay. So I do the, what is the formula says? A is first term square. Who is your first term? M. First term square plus second term square. B square is your second term. Okay. So who is your second term? 2n. Plus third term square. Who is your third term? 3r square. Plus 2 into a into b. That is 2 into first term into second term. Who is your first term? M. And who is the second term? 2n. Right? Plus 2 into second term into third term. This one. Second term and third term. Who is the second term? 2n and 3r. So write 2n and 3r. Plus last one you will say 2 into first term into third term. First term into third term. Who is your first term? M. Last term is 3r. Easy? So it's a very easy formula basically, boys. Okay? So I get m square plus 2 ka square is 4, n square. 3 ka square is 9. 3 square, 3 into 3 is 9. Remember, r square plus 2 2's are 4, mn plus 2 2's are 4, 4 3's are 12. So 12 nr plus 2 into 3, 6 mr. So this is your answer. So this becomes your answer. You can box it if you want to. Clear? So boys, we know I did the second sum. Now I'll do the fourth sum. First and third sum you'll have to do for homework. Practice. Okay? Because unless you practice, you'll not learn. So I finished the second sum. Now I'm doing the fourth sum. The first and the third sum are practice at 5.4 expand. The first and third sum you do it for homework. Okay? So I'm doing the fourth sum now. A fourth sum is slightly different. There is a small problem if you notice. Just see what is the problem if you can notice. Look at this formula and look at this. What do you feel is the difference? Ah, that is a problem. Very good. That means here is there is no problem. The first term is positive, but this second and third term has got a negative sign. Now I cannot apply this formula this formula is meant only when there is a what in between plus sign. So how do I use it for a negative? If there is a negative sign, you have to use little bit of, you have to use a small technique. What do? You have to convert all of them into positive sign. You have to bring a positive sign in between. So now what I'll do is, so let's say I've got these terms are there, okay? So I'll say 7m, okay? Now I'll write minus 3n, CF, 7m, I write minus 3n, and I'll write minus 4k, and I will open the bracket, and I'll say the whole square, and I'll put a plus in between. Is it, can I do that? Of course, yes. Look at this. This is already plus, so no problem. Here also it is plus, no issues. Now look at this. What is plus into minus, boys? Plus into minus is minus. So here also is minus. So plus into minus, minus. So I have not changed the value. Only thing I little a smart work. And here what is plus into minus? Minus. So instead of adding minus, I wrote plus into minus because I wanted plus sign. Now can I use the formula? Yes. So this whole thing becomes my A, minus 3n becomes my B, and minus 4k becomes my C. So I get A plus B plus C, the whole cube. Easy? Understood what I did? Little smart work, okay? So that's how you have to play little smart. So you got C. Now I can use a formula. Otherwise I could not use because it's a negative term, no? So what did I put? I kept the negative sign as it is. I did not. 3 had a negative sign. Here also 3 has got negative sign. Here 4 has got a negative sign. Here also 4 has got negative sign. Only thing I put a plus. Because I know plus into minus is minus only. So let's use the formula. What is the formula saying? A square. Who's my A? 7m. A square plus B square. Who's my B square? Minus 3n. Okay, be careful. Minus 3n. Huh? Plus C square. So who's my C? My C is minus 4k. Plus 2 into A into B. 2 into first term into second term. Who's my first term? 7m. Who's my second term? Minus 3n. Okay? Same way. Plus 2 into A. 2 into second term into the third term. Who's the second term? Minus 3n. And here it is minus 4k. Finally, plus 2 into first term into third term. Who's your first term? First term is 7m. And this is minus 4k. Okay? Now, let's solve it. So what is 7 ka square? 49. 7 7s are 49. M square. Now, what is minus ka square? What is minus ka square means what? What is minus into minus? Plus. So minus into minus is plus. And plus into plus also is plus. So I'll get 9n square. Again the same story. Minus ka square kya hai? Plus. Minus into minus plus. So n plus into plus plus. 4 ka square 16, 16k square. I hope you are understanding. Then plus into, now here there is no sign. So what sign is there? If nobody has got, if a number doesn't have any sign on the left hand side, what sign is there? Positive. So here there is a plus. So plus into plus plus, plus into minus minus. 2 7s are 14, 14 3s are 42. M into N becomes MN. Then plus into minus, minus, minus into minus, plus. Be careful. Plus into minus, 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 plus. 2, 3 is a 6, 6, 4 is a 24. And then N into K becomes NK. Then here plus, here there is no sign. So what sign is there? Plus sign. So plus into plus plus, plus into minus minus. Okay. 2 7s are 14, 14 4s are 56. M into K, MK. So this is your answer. Okay. Only thing, be careful. Whenever there's a negative sign, you put a plus in between because this formula applies only if all the three terms are added. Okay, otherwise you cannot apply this formula. So little bit smart of Gila to do like this. Whenever there's a negative sign, if this is all positive, like in the second sum which I solved, everything was positive, so there was nothing to worry. But here you can do it. Okay.